cuckoo bird of Austwick. Come on, Phil! You can do it!
Hello, today we're in Austwick doing Austwick Amble Fell Race, which is 8 miles long with 1,200 feet elevation. The children are doing their junior races. Vladimir's doing under 19 and Olivia will under 13 race.
Austwick is a little village, a hamlet near Settle in North Yorkshire Dales. Many years ago, when winters were a little harsher than usual, people welcomed cuckoo birds nesting in the trees or stealing other nests as a sign of spring. This is now remembered on the second May bank holiday each year with a festival, fell race and other family entertainment in Austwick. Cheerfully looking handmade cuckoo birds were spread all around the village. The front of people's cottages were blooming with fragrant spring flowers. The public was continuously entertained by different performances, games and stalls, and live music. There were also these two glamorous shire horses with a fancy cart with beer barrels in front of the game cork pub. I went to stroke those gentle beauties. We arrived in plenty of time, so we had time to do all this, as well as take pictures with horses and the cuckoo bird. The race registration was in a tent outside the game cork pub. We registered online, so we quickly received our numbers. Entries on the day were still available, but a little bit higher. It was a very hot day, so waterproof jacket was not essential, but only recommended. Andy Evans from Settle Harriers was the race director. From our Preston Harriers club, we had 10 juniors taking part of various age categories. Under 11, under 13, under 15, under 17, and under 19. Here are the older boys and 10 seniors. The start line for junior and senior races was next to the sign for the game cork pub. Before setting off, all the children of different age categories were counted through the funnel, so they would know how many children set off and how many children should come back. And this is under 11 and under 13 race. Off they go. This is under 13 girl who beat the previous course record. I only filmed a few of the finishers, not everyone. Under 15, under 17, under 19 children are getting ready to start. They started together but ran different courses. From the road it goes onto the fell. While waiting for the children to come back, we were being entertained by the musical quartet. Thank you. Here's the first under 15 finisher. And the second one from Settle Harriers. I also filmed only a few juniors finishing, not all of them. Vladimir is looking happy after the race. As soon as the junior races finish, then the senior race will start.
Hello?
It's lovely to have an ice cream after the race on a hot day. And here we have seniors gathering together outside the pub at the start line.
Andy, you missed the picture, the group photo. Where?
We were counted by going through the funnel too. And off we go! Before going up onto the fells, we run along the main street of the village. Here, Russell, my husband, filmed the runners going up the tarmac lane, but his image on the phone is not as clear.
That's the last I will have of you, Mick. That's why.
And this is where the track is starting to ascend up the fells.
Come on, Phil! You can do it! I love this rock formation. Beautiful.
This race was 8 miles in distance and the overall elevation was about 1,100 feet. So it wasn't very steep over the distance. However, the day was really hot and it was so difficult to run in the heat. Once we ascended, it was more or less all of the elevation. And then for miles and miles, we were running on the flattish ground. On both sides of us, we had famous Yorkshire limestone formation.
That is good.
The running Ronnie was leading the way for a while. On the left-hand side, we had Ingleborough and on the right, Penigent. This kern, the pile of stones, was our official checkpoint too, from which we turned slightly right and then downwards. Now we have the view of Penigent in front of us.
Wow, look at this. I'm gonna come closer to this. That is cool. Look at this sea of limestone. This is my favorite place coming up with limestones, like a limestone corridor.
At this checkpoint, we turned right, going back on ourselves on a lower path. Just further down, there were some marshals who gave me a sip of water out of their bottle.
Well done.
Just look at this gorgeous sea of the limestone formation.
This water is the best, gonna be the best. I'll add some water, but this last bit on the gravel path is a torture. It's like a desert running. Look at this village. Austwick. Thank you. A little bit.
How'd you find the race?
Really, really tough. It's not my kind of race. I don't mind the steep up, steep down, but this is just constant running on the hard surface in the sun. It's not my cup of tea. I just am rubbish. I'm rubbish. I'm something. That's it. There you go. Let's go enjoy ourselves.
I'm sorry, I was being very negative before when Vladimir asked me how the race was. It was great, actually. It was just very tough today because it was very hot and there was a lot of runnable bits with hard surface and no shade and I'm rubbish in the heat. But it was a great race overall.
Here my husband filled some of the runners on his phone. That's the first finisher who beat the course record, the previous year's course record. And that's the second finisher. And that's the third one from Rossendale. These are a few more people finishing the race, filmed by my husband on his phone. The quality of the image is not so good, but still you can tell who these people are.
This is an appropriate sign for the person underneath, Norbert.
Oh,
Nice, mate. Come on.
Well done, mate.
I filmed a little bit of the presentation as well.
And Andy also takes the £50 bonus for the UCOS record.
Well done.
And his second place.
That's very good. Thanks.
And in third place, Jonathan Cleaver from Rossendale in 49.49. From Longsdale, 58.27. And in third place, Emily Jones from Wharfdale, 59.05. Team boys, from Preston Harriers, Vladimir Wiggins. Well done.
Thank you for watching. Until next time, and goodbye.